What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. But in this case, let's hope the women have a little extra hardware to bring back home and not the hangover. West Virginia would respond, you gotta box out, otherwise Devin Williams may put you on a poster plus the foul. Breaking ankles all over the defenders, and he drills the three. Ice cold, baby. Taylor with a clutch shot. That boy better get a couple more ankle braces, because that he's going to be feeling that one after a while. Utah wins it. Happy opening day, everybody. I am Luke Lyddon with your Look At Sports. It is time for your peanuts and your Cracker Jacks. And, of course, a $12 beer, because there is nothing quite like America's pastime. It's about time they make this day a holiday. And it's also about time we get to these highlights of the Pirates and the Cardinals. And, man, does it feel good to say that. Just pull off the comeback, 68-62, and they are headed to the Final Four. Syracuse to the Final Four, said no one ever, which is why my bracket is an absolute shame to look at. The UTEP Miners basketball season reminds me of a Katy Perry song, sometimes so hot and then sometimes just so cold.
Have a timeout, decide not to use it. Curry, way downtown, bang, bang! Oh, what a shot from Curry!
No, he didn't, just stop it. In overtime, tie game, Curry heaves a 32-footer, and he drops it like it's hot. And look at those dance moves, too. Ice cold. Warriors come back, and they win it in overtime. Just look at it one more time. Oh, my goodness. 121-118, your final. Can you believe that? 32 feet out. That man is absolutely unguardable. Warriors only led 29 seconds the entire game, but that play, that's just mean. And with that madness, I say happy Saturday, everybody. I'm Luke Lyddon with your Look At Sports.
We're joined by a man who attracts the crowd wherever he goes. That would be Luke Lyddon. Luke, how's it going, man?
Trevor, there's already a big crowd filling into the Don right now, but I don't think it's because of me. It's because of the Miners' biggest home game of the year so far, taking on the Oregon Ducks in the Elite Eight of the WNIT. There is one, maybe even two NFL teams that can now say this.
I'm going back to Cali, Cali.
I'll let you know which team coming up after the break. Valentine's Day, everybody. I'm Luke Lyddon with your Look At Sports. Love is in the air. Well, not really if you don't have a significant other like myself, but it's okay. Cupid could always change that. Oh, I think I found my Valentine, Alex Smith, Chiefs Kingdom. But in reality, the best part about Cupid's birthday is tomorrow, when all the chocolate goes on sale. As for Michigan State, today has always been special for Denzel Valentine, and it looks like Denzel will be a lucky, lucky man tonight.
Jimmy Johnson.
Holy crap. Oh, my goodness. I have never seen anything like, oh, my gosh.
Talk about seeing life flash right before your eyes. Driving in the Geico 500, Dale Earnhardt Jr. steering wheel just comes off, and he's holding onto the steering column for dear life. That man going 200 miles an hour, and that steering wheel just falls off. Are you kidding? Talk about keeping your cool. I don't know about you, but my car, it doesn't come that way. And with that nightmare, I say good evening to all of you at home. I'm Luke Lyddon with your Look At Sports. Trevor, we are live here ringside at the ballpark, and the atmosphere is just starting to pick up. We got the music going, the fight card is ready, the ring is ready, and the weather couldn't be more ideal for a night full of boxing. But more importantly, Jen Han looking to defend her world boxing title against Kalista Salgado. Hassan Duna on both sides of the floor. Just throw it up as high as you can and then watch it unfold. The rainbow lob finished by Whiteside. The man is just mad at the rim. We've already come to the realization our brackets are in the trash. Ripped up, set on fire, just not good. You get the point. So now we can actually enjoy the games on our screen.
They came out against this Capitals team, but
oh no! A dump in from beyond center squirts through.
Oh boy, this has to be the worst possible feeling for a goalie in a hockey game. Capitals' Carl Alzner dumps the puck into the Flyer zone, and somehow it finds its way into the net for the goal. You gotta cover that five hole. Flyers lose 4-1. What a day to be alive. Well, maybe not for goalie Steve Mason, but everyone else, yes. We had the NHL playoffs, NBA playoffs, and spring football. The list really just goes on and on. Getting all fancy behind the back to Draymond Green. and he finishes the play with a spot-up three. Green, you know he's trouble, messed around, got himself a triple-double. Thompson drops 37 as the Warriors win Game 1 easily, 118-106. A's hosting the Astros. Top of the first, still scoreless, but funny how that can all change in just one play. Jose Altuve takes the pitch deep to left center, and probably a good thing it didn't hit the fans because they'd probably be throwing that one back in the outfield. Happy National Take a Chance Day, everybody. I am Luke Lyddon with your Lookout Sports. Yes, I kid you not, that's an actual real thing. I'm going to reach out on a limb here, take a chance, and say Drake's music is better than the team, his team, the Raptors. Bold statement, I know, but hey, the East needs some love too. Game 4 between Toronto and Indiana. Kentucky's Jamal Murray with the big dunk and one, hanging on the rim like it's a jungle gym. My goodness. And as mama always taught you, Sharon is Karen. Off the give and go. Kentucky takes the lead from deep, and they win it 93-80. And you know this is gone from the moment it hits the bat, and here comes the souvenir. Giovanni Soto hits a deep solo shot into the stands.
I wonder if Hardy looked for Giselle's sister in the stands. You know, I bet he did. In the fourth quarter, Brady says to Hardy, how about you keep your eyes off my wife and take a look at this touchdown pass. Julian Edelman, who breaks free, makes basically the entire secondary miss, falls into the end zone. Can you believe it? Denny Hamlin in the 11 and Martin Truex neck and neck at the finish line, and Hamlin wins in a photo finish by 1/100th of a second. Probably the closest finish you will see in any sport ever. Hamlin and his team celebrating for good reason. I would not want to be in the losing car of that race. 1/100th of an inch. That's like this much, or maybe even less. I don't know, but absolutely incredible. That is what NASCAR is all about. There is one thing I learned after watching that fight. I will never, and I mean never, step foot in that octagon, even if you paid me. You saw what happened to their face, and as the saying goes, you just got to protect the moneymaker. He's done it yet again. Magic's Aaron Gordon proving why he should have won this year's dunk contest. That man can fly. Magic win 130-116. A 39-inch vertical. Just jumping into a whole nother atmosphere. That's pretty impressive. The NBA All-Star Game. The one time a year both teams have no regard for playing defense and instead just throw up oop after oop. I don't think Don Haskins would approve. But it was the All-Star MVP that stole the show. Westbrook soaring to the moon and back with the ferocious slam. And just a fair warning, he did that a lot more than once. I mean, the guy, oh my goodness, he just did it all from downtown, down low. It's obvious Westbrook shared the love in more than one way tonight. We like to call that OBJ 2.0. But despite that effort, Giants lose 20-14. Hey, you know what? Let's try that. Hey, Anton, hit him with the pass real fast. See, I got that. I didn't have any help. Just like OBJ, right? And with that, I say good evening. I'm Luke. 22 years to be exact since the last time the Kansas City Chiefs clinched a playoff win. And I got to be real with all you viewers out there. I was this big, basically, since the Chiefs won in the postseason. Breaking news. The Cowboys have made it to the Super Bowl.
What?
Too soon? Too soon. But there is some positive news coming out of Jerry World. A very familiar face has made the active 53-man roster. Find out who? Coming up next. Danny, we got another week of exciting matchups, and one of them starts right here at Canutillo as the Eagles are hosting the Eastwood Troopers in tonight's game. If you take a look behind me, you'll see the players from both teams are warming up. The students and parents are slowly rolling into the bleachers, and we got about 45 minutes till kickoff.
He is a giant chicken.
And I cannot see, I can't see anything, so you're going to have to...
You can't see anything?
I can't. I'm just going, this is what my career has come to. It's Halloween. Just enjoy it. You got to take this, though. I can't. The ocean is truly the world of the unknown, and if you're not careful, then maybe something like that is going to happen. But in actuality, when we step foot in the ocean, we're basically playing the shark's backyard, and surfer Mick Fanning is just lucky to be alive after a huge shark attacks him on a surfboard at a surfing tournament off the coast of South Africa.
This marks the second week of practice for the Utah Meyer Hockey Club, and they're getting ready for their home opener against Texas Tech. And the players I spoke with are excited for the upcoming season.
Happy Halloween. I am Luke Lyddon with your Lookout Sports.
Ah!
They also call me Count Lucula. It is the day of the Walking Dead, and can you tell I like Halloween?
These players right here are going to demonstrate a Seahawk tackle, which actually takes the head out of the tackle. Boys, take it away.
And at the start of the day, it looked as if the Miners were going to get at least one win on the road. A promising sign as UTEP took on a poor 3-14 UTSA team. Oh, that's easy. No way they'll have a chance. But when you think like that, sometimes bad things happen. But like former Dallas Cowboy Dave Whittle says, turnovers are like ex-wives. The more you have, the more they cost you.
Las Cruces and Mayfield are co-game of the week. And you can see the Las Cruces Sun News. They are they're a little excited for this one. Both teams undefeated in district play. Mayfield is looking to get its third straight district title. But Las Cruces, they are having none of that.
It's a game of soccer, but with a twist, better known as bubble soccer, all developed by an El Paso-based business called Bubble Busters.
You're in a TPU bubble, which is being wrapped in bubble wrap.
It was only fair my sports director, Danny Mata, and I decided to put these bubbles to the test on the playing field after we suited up in a simple harness.
Like this, right?
Yeah, go all the way in there.
All right.
All the way. There you go.
That's not fair.
Woo! There we go.
He's got more legs to work with than I do. That's the thing.
I do.
He has way more legs than I do.
It was time to see how these really worked.
A little nervous. I don't know how this is going to work. A little top heavy.
Go! And the best part? You are 100% safe.
It's a secured spot that's inside the bubble where there isn't much room for head trauma or anything of that nature.
Which means anything goes.
Luke.Lyddon plays dirty. He plays very dirty. And I'm going to have my vengeance before long.
But the bigger they are, the harder they fall. And to prove just how sturdy these bubbles are, Danny and I decided to go one-on-one.
Yeah!
A new sport that will have you wanting more every bounce you take. Luke.Lyddon, ABC 7.